There's a major dispute over the significance of new evidence in the death of a Clemson University fraternity pledge. 19-year-old Tucker Hipps was found dead in a South Carolina lake last September, and his family has filed a $25 million lawsuit that cites a new witness who says three fraternity brothers forced the pledge to walk along a narrow railing on a bridge. The witness says that is when Hipps slipped, falling headfirst into the water below and then hitting his head on some rocks. The lawsuit claims the other students did not try to rescue Hipps and didn't even call police for help for another 7 hours. All the fraternity brothers named in the lawsuit are denying the allegations. So let's bring in psychologist Eric Fisher. Even though we don't know all of the facts of the case, all right. that preceded this horrible occurrence of the death of a 19-year-old, is there any way to kind of get into the mind of, you know, this alleged pledge who took a challenge possibly to walk on this rail to know that potentially this was a life or death decision?
Well, I think what we have to look at is hazing goes far beyond fraternity and sorority populations. It happens as early as high school situations, where there's a case in Parkview High School in Atlanta here about a student that was physically beaten in a hotel room in a hazing incident. But the whole issue of hazing is in order to get into an exclusive organization, you're supposed to go through some trials and rituals. They don't have to be humiliating, but often the fear is if I don't live up to what other people want, then I'm weak. It's about shaming and humiliating from the people who are trying to haze that person. And we have to change our culture, because this is not a fraternity, sorority, or club thing. It's a cultural thing that we have to look at having power over people versus really have to teach our kids how to have power with people.